Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. Today we want to take a look at a couple of legend attacks, since everything basically is over which I did over the last couple of days, which means like Clan War League. I posted all the bases which I wanted to post, so we should get back to Legend League. And what I'm doing over here is, first I'm adding like a black bar when I'm showing the replays in the beginning of the attack, just to make sure that you guys cannot already say, okay, this is gonna be a time fail, or this is gonna be already a triple based on the time. Obviously, sometimes I put in a couple of fails, even though it might be good on time. But this should make it a bit more interesting for you guys to watch, and I hope you guys like this idea. But first, let's get to the attacks, because we want to take a look where exactly did we finish over the day, because you could see already in the thumbnail, we finished first in Germany, but where exactly did we finish up in the global rankings? So let's get into the attack. On this one, this is a pretty common base, I guess, which I saw already a couple of times in Legend League, and this is super annoying to attack. And one thing which I came up with is just charging into all of the expos. It sounds kind of strange, but somehow it works. So what I'm using for this, I'm using the ram just to make sure that my queen and the queen charge itself, it's getting like a little bit more tanky. And adding a little bit more HP. And then the next thing what I like to do is adding just the hybrid for the queen walk to support everything. One thing as well is, if you guys, or like as you guys notice, there are a couple of small lags in there. Since I have like a new recording PC, and well, so far it's not working as intended. So yeah, I'm super sorry for that. I hope tomorrow it's fixed. But I guess there are a couple of drivers, whatever, missing. And yeah, hopefully fix that later today. But for now, let's get into the attack and let's enjoy what we're watching, at least the attacks and the ideas. And so far everything is looking good, with one big mistake which I did. I don't know if you guys spot that, but since my king went not as I planned on the outside, a lot of miners split from the inner group to the outside, which means there's a huge group of miners on the outside going around the base and not following the inside as we planned. So this is kind of upsetting. My queen died already against the enemy queen, but this means the healers swapped from the queen to our mines in the core, which makes this attack looks way better, and in the end gives us the power to push for the 3-star, because the miners died in the core with the support of the healers, but the clutch loons will finish up the single inferno tower, and with this is gonna be a triple in the end, and we have our first 3-star for the video. I guess this is a good start, and let's hope for many more triples to come, and let's see how the next attack will go. But first, if you guys like my content, if you guys would like to support me, there's a really easy way to do for you guys. If you guys go in your in-game settings, in your settings, you can find over there the creator boost code. If you type that in over there, just iTzu, you will support me whenever you're buying something in-game. But always remember, every 7 days, this code is getting basically deleted, and you guys have to retype it in to make sure, well, to support me. So if you're buying, for example, any of the offers or buying the gold pass, etc., you can support me with using my code. Thank you guys so much. Let's get back into the next attack. And this one is on Stephanie. This is actually a fresh base, which I never saw before. And it's kind of like building on this style which is evolving right now, with having the 3 heroes in combination with the 3 single inferno towers on one side and 4 ground explos on the other. What exactly is this doing? This is doing basically that you have to decide, what do you want to charge? You could go into 4 ground explos with scatter shots in between, or you could go into 3 single inferno towers with, well, heroes in there, which isn't the best choice, one of those. So what I decided for, I went for one of the single inferno towers to first loot the CC, and second of all, make sure that the single inferno tower cannot roast my queen. And the next thing is, obviously, you guys have to make sure that you always know when to use the rage for the Yeti Blimp and when you don't. On this one, I did not have to use the rage because there was just basically not needed. So we have one rage already saved, which means we have 3 rages for our queen charge, which is always a crazy amount of rages and power for our queen charge. And then the next thing, this idea was just basically to charge into this entire really long channel. And yeah, I had the option, like with this, I'm kind of avoiding the sweepers and obviously most of the damage. But still, since there are still a lot of damaged buildings around the town hall. I somehow need to protect my queen, otherwise she might die even though I will rage her. So what I thought, okay, let's push with the hybrid into the town hall with making sure that the king is clearing the outside buildings. And this should make sure that everything is working like next to each other basically. The queen in the core, then it's the hybrid, and then it's the king on the outside. With this everything together basically and next to each other, we're splitting the damage, which means it's less damage overall, which are considered being on one troop. The tornado trap sadly rotated my queen away from the eagle, which gives me a huge issue because I have only two heals. And this attack would have been nice to have three heals, but I cannot change my spells obviously. So this is why the eagle is going down kind of late, and this causes a lot of miners and hawk riders to die. So at this point we have only a couple of hawk riders left, and we have only a couple of miners left which are cleaning up the right side. So what I'm doing right now, I'm just trying to save my royal champion and give her as many possibilities basically to be as useful as possible. And with this, the royal champion is taking out the single inferno tower, which is clutch. And now I'm trying to warbreak my queen in, using the rage over there as well to support my queen, but as well the mimes as well to speed those things up. I think I could have dropped the rage a bit more deeper to make sure that my queen is like benefiting longer from the rage. But either way, my queen is making it through. And so far it's looking really good. We have one more loon, one minion obviously to place. And this is looking really good for us. So both of the Tesla are going down, queen ability is still up. And this means this is going to be a triple for us. This means this day is going crazy, crazy good for us. So I think what we should do is get into the last attack for the video and then check out where exactly did we finish up global on the last day. So let's get into the next attack, which is obviously once again going to be Queen Charge Hybrid. I just love the attack right now. It's a lot of fun. And this base is actually pretty tricky. You can see I'm not placing any troops for a pretty long time because I had to think about this base a long time. There are a couple of options which you could do. You could charge in one of the single inferno tower compartments. You could charge in from the bottom of the base for the eagle. You could charge in from the top side of the base for the town hall. But what you could do as well, you could charge kind of in between of everything. What this does is you have to funnel perfectly and you have to make sure that everything is basically covered so your queen and your healers are not dying. So what I did over here, I start off with my queen. I try to charge in between of the town hall and the single inferno tower. But what this does, I need to take out the single inferno tower. And once again, I'm using the Yeti blimp for that. And once again, we are not using any rages for the Yeti blimp because it's just not needed. If you just want to take out one inferno tower, you do not need a rage. If you want to take out basically like another scatter shot, whatever, then you sometimes need the rage and just like power everything up basically. So what I'm doing over here, I'm breaking my queen in. And at this point I thought, like, okay, if this is like the only thing how this attack can fail if my queen is dying kind of quickly. So this is why I decided I bring just two Kirkudoons and hope for the best. Already one black man out of the way. And now the queen is taking care of the enemy queen. She cannot reach the town hall, but that's totally fine. We would start over there with our hybrid. And then obviously just taking care of the enemy CC. Really nicely timed with the enemy single inferno tower because that's not on our queen during the kill of the enemy lava hound. Now the king on the outside and now everything into the town as soon as all of the pups are gone. So what I'm doing over here, I'm always like the deploy order because that's kind of important. If you do not start at the outside of the build or like start off the outside of the base, but instead you have to like deploy your troops and they're going deeper into the base with their first target, you should always have the deploy order of the warden, then you should deploy the miners, and then you can basically decide if you want to use the hawk riders and then the royal champ or the other way around. But it's really important that you're deploying the warden first, otherwise the miners will get ahead of the warden, the warden cannot follow, and this means the miners are getting huge damage and you cannot use the warden ability if you want to. This is an important thing, especially when you're using hybrid, to like remember this deploy order basically. Now this one, it's important that my royal champions once again stayed really long alive, use her ability, and now the miners and everything is coming in, which is important as well. My queen stayed alive and she can save the attack in the end to get the next three stars for us. Which means the day actually went super well for us. I will show you guys the result in a second, but let's enjoy the last couple of miners getting rid of the last buildings. Meanwhile, the queen is getting taking care of the last couple of things. And one more thing, if you have warbreakers in the end still to place them where they are where they target the wall, which is touching buildings on both sides. This gives you like a little bit more of damage. But yeah, this was the day yesterday, plus 290, which isn't too bad, minus 203, which is a pretty good result considering the defense at the top. And yeah, plus 87 trophies overall, which is really, really good. So as I guys already told you, right now we're number one in Germany, even though it's always like a really close race at the top three. Like Aquaria, I cannot pronounce the name, and me, we're always really close to each other. But that's right now the ranking in the global leaderboard, number 16 at that point. I think we finished on number 40 in the day. And yeah, now it's all about keeping the momentum up. Obviously, my goal is to finish up in the top 10. That will be awesome. And like, obviously, the trophy record for me personally would be nice if I have above 7k trophies, which I think is easier to accomplish than the other one. But either way, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Once again, I'm super sorry for all of the lags and stuttering. I hope it's fixed for tomorrow. Like I said, a new recording PC. And not everything is going as smooth as planned. So I'm sorry for that. I hope you guys still enjoyed today's video. And I hope I see you guys back tomorrow for another video. Until then, see you guys and bye-bye.